Hello everyone, welcome to this another interesting video where we learn how to make an interactive image. Right, so in the interactive image we can see how we can add various tags so that we give a compiled image having a lots of information to our students. For that we need to type on our browser thinglink. Right, we'll just type thinglink and click on this. If you are using it for the first time, then we have to sign up. But I already have my account here, so I'll just log in. Now, when I log in, this is the home page. You will have certain less videos if you are using it for the first time. Now, what all we can do using thinglink? If you see here on the left side, you can see that there are three options. You can create an interactive image, you can create an interactive video, and you can also create a 360 degree view that you can show to your students. So we are starting with an image. For that, just click on image and go to create. Now, as soon as I go to create, it asks me to upload a particular image. So I can select any image from the device that I have and it will upload my image, which is then ready to be made interactive. Now this is my base image. Again, I am working on insurance. Now on this left hand side, we have certain options. So we'll click on this add tag. As soon as I click on add tag, I get this plus button here, right? So I can drag it anywhere, wherever you want to have this tag. All right. So let me have this tag here. And what you want to add? You want to add a text and media? You want to add a text label? Or you want to add content from website? So let us start one by one. First, I'll click on this add text and media. You can also change how this tag is looking. I think it's very boring, so I will go to change icon. I will click on this and I can select any of these options that are given to me free. So let me take this home image. You can also change the color. So you can see how my tag is appearing now. Here you need to add the title. So I have written insurance. And you can add anything in the description. You can also copy it from the internet or from any of the work that you already have, or you can simply type. Let us just go to Google and type benefits of insurance. As soon as I type on benefits of insurance, I get various options. I can just copy it from here and I can paste it over here, right? Button URL, if you want to give any link to the YouTube video, we can also do that. So for that, I'll just select any video from YouTube, taking care about the Creative Commons. I'll copy the link and I'll put it here, all right? And you don't want it to appear like YouTube, so I'll write benefits, whatever you want to appear on the button. All right. Now I can also add certain images here. So for that, click on this plus and select any of the image from your device. You can select multiple images. You can also select the videos. So I have selected few images. Alright, so these are the images that I have selected. You can select more. You can also upload any audio from your device if you want to do that. But I think it is enough from my side. So I'll go to this done. As soon as I go to done, all my information is compiled in this one simple tag that we'll see once our image is ready. Let us add another tag. And this time let us add a text or table. I'll again change the icon and I'll select, let me select this. Alright, so I have selected this. You can add a text again. So let us type different types of insurance in India. So we get this. You have to be careful when you are using it. I'm just showing it to you. Right, so I'll select this text. Alright, and I'll try and copy it here. Alright, so it is still giving me the YouTube link. Let me just copy it and try pasting it here. Okay, so it will only take 100 characters here. Alright, I'll click on done. I'll again add a tag and I'll go to add content from website. I'll again change the icon. Right, and I'll take a URL from the YouTube. You can take any link. I'm using the same one because I just want to show you how it will appear. And I'll click on done. So once all my tags are ready, alright, otherwise if you don't shift the position of the tags, all of them would be under one tab only. I don't want that to happen, right? So again, now just go to this done here and my interactive image is ready. Let us see how it will appear. These are my three tags on this image. If I click on this, you can see there is this text, there is this YouTube link that we have shared, right? So students can see this, and there are these images which can be moved like this, right? So students will get all the information. There is one more option. You can see this book with a speaker sign. If we click on this, then what will happen? And if we play here,
insurance is a cooperative device which helps to share the risks among the insured.
Alright, so this is the automatic function in this thing link. Let me close this tag. Let us go to this another one. And as soon as I click here, this text pops up. Right, so students would be able to view. I can write a small text here which students can read and understand. This is the tag that I used for my YouTube video. Right, so as soon as I click on this, this video pops up which the students can view. So this is how you can make an interactive image, and one image would portray the whole story to the students, and your session is going to be quite interesting. Now let us go back to our thing link and see where this image is. So this was my image. I can share it. So for sharing it with your students, click on share, and we have these various options. You can embed this, so you can take this embedded code and you can just put it in the LMS where this image would be available. You can also share the link. So you'll simply copy this, right? You'll simply copy this and you can send it to your students via the mail or via the WhatsApp. If you want to publish to social, so there are various medias. You can see that Google Classroom is also appearing here, right? So it can be published directly to the Teams, to Google Classroom, to your social media, Twitter, and various others. If you want to download it offline, that is possible only if I upgrade my account. Alright, so these are the various options that can be done. Now let us go back, and if I want to delete something, then on my home page, I am getting these three buttons. I will just click on this and I will go to delete. Right, so this particular image has been deleted. Now let us just have a look how the interactive videos would appear. For that, we need to click on this videos, and this is an existing video on ThingLink. You can see how instead of the image, now you will have a video and you can have various tags here. Similarly, we can have a 360 degree view also. Let us click on something. So this is a 360 degree image which is already there on the ThingLink. You can also make your image. You can also use this version. Let us just wait for it to start. So this is how a 360 degree view would appear with various tags. So it is very useful for geographical archaeology subjects which the students can learn. I hope you enjoyed this session and you would be using this ThingLink in your interactive classes and your blended classroom sessions. Thank you so much.